Hello everybody. So today we're looking at Bitcoin and analyzing data related to Bitcoin. So we're going to be using something called Glassnode, and we're going to be using an API which we'll register for, and we'll be analyzing something called the spend output profit ratio. So if you've been living under a stone for the past couple of years, then let me just introduce Bitcoin. Bitcoin is one of the cryptocurrencies which uses the blockchain technology. And because it's on a blockchain, it's basically a public ledger. So information is available as to buys and sells. So it's much more visible than other types of investment. And as you can see, the global crypto market is now $2.37 trillion, overtaking the market cap of Apple. So I think it's fair to say that it's going to be around for a while at least. So while it is, let's make some sense of the data. So if you register with Glassnode, Glassnode is, as far as I know, it's the main place to analyze information, and they provide an API which allows you to use whatever code you want, but obviously they've provided a curl example, HTTP, and this is what we're interested in, example using Python. So we're going to start with this code, and once we've got an API key, see line 7, you just register for the API key and it's free. It gives you access to many, many things, but not everything, obviously. As usual, they want you to register, which is fair enough. So import JSON, import requests, import pandas as PD, API key, and then you put your API key in between those quotes. And then res, response, equals requests.get, and then this URL. And there's various different endpoints, but here we're looking at SOPR. And then we're going to pass it the A, which is the ticker code basically for the cryptocurrency. So we're going to put BTC. If you wanted to do Ethereum, you'd put ETH there and so on. And then API key, which is that variable there, which is the same as that variable, which is what you put inside the quotes. And then you convert it to Pandas data frame. So once you've got it as a Pandas data frame, then you can make a nice graph or scatter plot and so on. So without further ado, let's just quickly recap on SOPR. SOPR values greater than one implies that people are on average selling at a profit. So they know from looking at the blockchain what price something was paid, and then they know what's the price something was sold at. And if you've got sellers selling at a loss, it means they probably want to get hold of their money before they anticipate a big drop in the price. And if you've got people selling at a profit, they're probably taking a profit because there's been a recent big steep increase in the price and they want to sell it before any potential downside. So it's all on here, insights.glassnode.com. I've already registered for the key. So without further ado, let's just look at the code that I've written and we'll see some output it towards the end. And then we'll just talk about what other things you might be able to do with this. So as per their code, I've imported JSON, requests, pandas. I've also imported NumPy. And from scipy.stats import lin regress, and that allows you to create a linear regression line for your plot. And also I've imported cbon just to give it some kind of dark theme to the graph. That's not essential, but it just makes it look nicer. So matplotlib.pyplot, you can use plotlib dash whatever. So I'm sticking with matplotlib here. The focus of this is on collecting the information and making sense of it. If you want to make a different graph, then feel free to use different. So here we go. Don't try and use this API key because I've generated a new one, so that's now defunct. I thought I'd use the API key in this because in the past, When I was a real beginner, I used to get the API key, and I could never tell whether you had to keep it in the quotes or not. Yeah, so it does say you do need the quotes because it's a string, and then paste in your API key. And as we just saw, that's the same from the example on Glassnode. So here's the new bit. So what we do is df dot df. So the data frame, pandas data frame equals pandas data frame dot read underscore JSON. So it's reading the JSON response. So it's reading into JSON the response text. And we're just interested in the last 120 days data. You can choose whatever you want there. So tail obviously gives you the last part of the data frame. So that if you put head, it would get you the top of the data frame, which would be the oldest, or going back as far as you can. Tail gives you your most recent results. So experiment with tail and head, you'll get the hang of it. X, so the x-axis typically will be time. If you're graphing something with time, it will go along the x-axis. And the y, the vertical axis, will be the SOPR, which stands for spent output profit ratio. And yeah, here, stats. So stats equals lin regress x and y. So we're taking the date. And here I'm just using the date as the number since the epoch. M equals stats.slope, so that's the gradient, and then the stats.intercept, which is where the line would begin from on the y-axis. So then we do figure, plot figure, then we're just going to create some x-axis, set some ticks, which we're not even displaying. Yeah, so AX plot, that's the color for the linear regression line. And then AX.setLabel, so we're putting a label there, what that's the days along the x-axis, profit up the vertical. And plot.scatter or plt.scatter, X, Y, S equals 50, that's the size of the dots. And I'm doing C here. So C is the third variable, which relates to the color, and it varies. So the more recent the dot, so obviously the very right-hand end here is the most recent, they will be darker, and then the old ones will be lighter. I just thought it was a good way to show which is kind of the more relevant, or the more kind of the more relevant. But you need to see all of them to get an overall picture. SNS, so that's the seaborne bits, and then plot.show. So what we eventually ended up with is you can see over the past, was that a third of a year? The price kind of, it's pretty much mirrors the price movements, really. So you can see that earlier in the year, price was going up. Then there was the big dip after the ban of crypto mining in China. And then pretty much the price recovered. So after that sell-off, where as you can see, we had people were selling at a loss, and then you can see a big increase here. And there's one, two, three, four. There was a bit of a dip in October, actually. But in general, you can see we'd need to analyze with doing some more stuff with a data frame. But you can see the majority of the dots are, so, I would say, even there at break even. So really, there's only one, two recent days where it's not broken even, and that's potentially people needing to, it might even be people needing to sell off Bitcoin so that they could go off and buy one of the new altcoins, you know, Shiba Inu or Ethereum or something. So and really, they're not really selling at much of a loss. As you can see, it's pretty much near, always near one. Yeah, and then 99. So it's even there, nobody's really making much of a loss other than the fees. So one of the things to consider if you are interested in buying Bitcoin is how you buy them. The fees can really add up. You can have fees for purchasing, And you can have fees for a credit card transaction if you fund with a credit card. And then also you've got the spread, which is the difference between the buy price and the sell price. So once you've bought some Bitcoin, you'll probably, well, you will certainly, you won't be in debt, but you'll be making a loss if you wanted to sell them immediately. So really, Bitcoin is a long-term investment if you're considering HODL, HODL is the phrase, hold on for dear life. So I just wanted to show you this and API, Glassnode, Glassnode docs, and we can get information from Glassnode. And if you go to API key studio, I believe, there are many, many graphs which are already pre-built for you. So I just wanted to use the API key with Python and just start looking at how I can make my own graphs. And potentially, for instance, if you wanted to make your own newsletter, you could generate your graphs with Python and you could save those images in a directory and then you could insert them into a Word document and email it out maybe once a week as a PDF to your subscribers. And obviously, if you send out somebody else's graph, then there's obviously the intellectual property and so on and so on. Whereas create your own graph, it's you're not infringing any copyright or anything. And obviously you can customize it as well, customize it into your own colors, red and green or whatever. So hopefully this has been interesting and I'll be back soon with some more crypto kind of API Python code stuff. So if you've got anything in particular you'd like me to show, then let me know in the comments. Otherwise, thank you for watching and don't forget the thumbs up, subscribe and all that. Thanks for watching.